You seem to have it all. You seem to have control. But deep within your soul, you're losing, yeah.
Just appreciate everybody being here today for a very powerful kickoff. Our Lord and the Holy Spirit, we're just here to invite him into our lives. And right now, Father God, we just, when two or more are gathered in your name, then you are among us. We stand by this in your word, and we just thank you. We thank you for being here with us. Lord, Father God, we just we ask that whatever words come out of my mouth today are of you and not of me. So let's start with your word from Chronicles 7. And God says, if my people who belong to me humble themselves, pray, seek to please me, and repudiate their sinful practices, and I will respond from heaven, forgive their sins, and heal their land. That's what we call a promise from God. And I'm sure that everybody has heard at some place or another that that God makes promises to us. Now, a promise from God is not like a promise from a human being, right? I mean, even when we take a vow or some covenant with somebody, let's say it's in the marriage, we take the vow of marriage, we accept the covenant, it still, in human terms, becomes very optional as to whether one or both of us is going to live out our days obedient to that promise or covenant. Different when God makes a promise to us. When God makes a promise to us, that's God. God's a holy God. And really, really, what does holy mean? Holy means unique. I mean, we can, of course, it means perfect, perfection, yes. But those are unique qualities. Okay, stands alone, and so don't his promises. So, again, let's go back there quickly. And we're going to read that again. It's so short. It's a couple of verses. Again, it's Chronicles 7:14. God's promise. If my people who belong to me humble themselves, okay, humility. Less of me, more of him. Less and less of me all the time and more of him. Pray. And obviously, that's putting our focus and attention on God's word and seeking relationship with him. And then it says, seek to please me, which prayer and obedience are pleasing to God, and repudiate their sinful ways, and turn and walk from those ways which we know are not holy. Then I will respond from heaven, forgive the sin, and heal their land. So it's very, very, very simple and very powerful. So you say, well, you know, how do I ever get good enough for that? And here's the great news. You can't be. You're never going to be good enough for that. I'm never going to be good enough for that. Okay? That isn't what God says. God doesn't say, well, if you're good enough. No. He says, if you do this, if you do these things, if you seek me, first, if you're a believer, okay, my people who believe in him, seek me and you pray and you repudiate sins, he will do this for you. So it's not like you qualify one way or the other than taking those actions and obedience. And frankly, that's what you're doing this morning. By taking a couple of minutes, coming together in fellowship here, trusting in him, seeking him to be a part of your day. Not just a part, but numero uno, number one. Father, we just ask that you touch us, we and our families today, for a day of prosperity in our businesses. That as we work, we satisfy the needs of our customers this morning, Father God, and throughout the day. That we do this in a highly profitable way, Father God. That money that you bless us with today be used for your purpose and glory, for the advancement of your kingdom. That you guide us in how to best care for our own families, Father God, as you care for us, Heavenly Father, as you care for your family here and your children here, that you teach us and guide us how to take care of our own family. And then, Father God, as we come under your authority, invite you into our life, seek you, pray that you fulfill your promises, that we also are able to come under the authority of our own bosses and the authority within our own households, so that you be blessed and you be glorified by our own actions. And of course, Father God, we ask for this and we thank you for this in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Well, you know, if you're a new Christian or really an unreborn Christian, let's say somebody that's, I know who Jesus is, but I want to know Jesus in a far more intimate way. That requires a submission from you. That's all. That's all it is. He's already died for you. He's already died for your sins so that you could be joined with God. We talk about a holy God. God cannot be joined with sin. So none of us are good enough not to sin. I mean, we all sin. I sin, you sin, we sin daily. So when God cannot be joined with that, what does that mean? Well, no, when our body dies and it's time to go to heaven, he can't be joined with that sin. That is what hell is. That's a separation from God. Hell is a separation from God, and simply because those are the rules. He cannot be joined with sin. So if we're not good enough not to sin, and he can't be joined with sin, how does that get reconciled? Well, it's reconciled and redeemed through the blood of his son, Jesus Christ, the perfect lamb, the perfect sacrifice that he could have made so that we be forgiven of our sins. And when our body dies and we go before the throne of judgment of God, all he sees is the blood of his son. All he sees is the blood of his son. How does that happen? Well, we have an intimate relationship with Christ, with Jesus. And how does that happen? Well, he's already given up his life for us. He's already has perfect love for us. We need to make a choice. We need to open our heart and will him into our life. Use our own free will. Allow him to do the things that he wants to do. So if you're at that place, okay, where you want to have an intimate relationship with Christ, be forgiven of your sin, and truly, truly know that you're going to heaven when your body dies, I ask you to say this prayer with me today, morning, and at the end say, amen, if you agree. If you don't agree, not your time, fine. But here's our prayer, okay? Repeat after me. Lord Jesus, I ask you to come into my heart. I accept you as Lord, Master, and Savior. I ask you to heal me and forgive me of my sins. Amen. That's it. That simple. So here we are. I believe I hit this exactly 10 minutes. I did it, right? Yeah, I hit it in 10 minutes. Not really. The Lord guides us through it. We hope to see you back here each and every Saturday, either at 8:15 Eastern or 11:15 Eastern. And that's to allow the many businesses, dealerships, and so on and so forth, which is part of our community, to get their sales meeting up and going, and then just tune in quickly for 10 minutes for this prayer. And I ask you to join us at Mark Ragsdale Ministries on Facebook. So it's facebook.com/Mark Ragsdale Ministries. We'll post more meetings and some videos and so on and so forth up there. So hey, have a great week, and God bless.
In your life, you seem to have it all, you seem to have control, but deep within your soul, you're losing.